Hey guys, and welcome to another video. This video will be episode 17? Yeah, 17 of my Resident Rise Let's Play. And I did some work between the episode, guys. I am extremely proud to show you this, because this is the first time ever I've made a system like this, not in a creative world. I added a quadrupling part to my system. So, basically this entire plant up to this block, the purification chamber, is simply to double or triple your ores. And thanks to Echo, I got this thing sorted out. First, it didn't really work properly. And then, between the episode, I managed to get this thing going. This awesome, incredibly expensive copper, which I will show you the recipe for in just a minute. Yeah. Quadrupling station. And pretty much what happens is this salination chamber, which I will show you right now. Salination chamber. I needed these blocks, which required 8 copper and a dynamic tank, which required some steel. And basically I needed, I don't even know exactly how much I needed of these blocks. Over 4 stacks, I believe it was. So basically I used over 22 stacks of copper simply making this thingy. But it's worth it. Because, well, basically, if you guys can see, I reset up the quarry. And, well, overnight it has been absolutely producing massive amounts of resources for me. So basically what happens is the thing produces brine from water over and some sunlight. Then it gets pumped into this electrolytic separator, which creates hydrogen and chlorine. Then it gets chemically infused, the chlorine and the hydrogen, into hydrogen chloride. Makes sense, of course. And that is getting pumped into this block, which is the chemical injection chamber. And why is this thing being so slow? Wow. Am I seriously out of power in this thing? Wow, this thing is insane. In a good way, though, sometimes. But yeah. I also took some of these speed upgrades out, because these things are currently... What? Oh. I thought like all of these were bumped up to 4 times. Basically, all the ores get put in here. You get 4 shards. The shards get put in this thingy, which gets you 4 of those other thingies, and then into this thingy, and this thingy, and this thingy, and this thingy. Yeah, simple as that. Then this thing, machine inventory manager, puts it into this chest. And the rest is basically just some item ducts doing its job, trying to place it in the nearby inventory, and basically the things that I get, massive amounts of coal, redstone, lapis, iron, blah, blah, blah. I got separate barrels, and the rest is going in here. And I didn't expect to get over a stack of iron overnight, so it's already filling up a bit more with iron. But, like, tons of resources, bunch of gold, some diamonds, shards, even a bunch of rocky bees, for some reason. And of course, my copper is getting back, redstone, yeah, pretty amazing. So, for this episode, I got some small things planned, and hopefully, well, get going on some other stuff. And, before I get going on anything else, I want to say that an update messed up quite some stuff over here. Pretty much the 2.6.17 update, which is the EXP build that we're currently in at the moment of recording, basically made it so that the fish traps from the mod Growthcraft no longer are in the pack. So yeah, that's kind of messed up, so I'm not getting any more power in here. And yeah, it's pretty much stopped working. Well, only the power system stopped working, the rest is still working fine, of course. But yeah, I'll still have to think of a solution for that someday, hopefully. Yeah, like I said, sooner or later, once I got the time and an idea for it. But today, what I want to do is, well, first of all, some more aesthetic stuff and maybe some terrain working around her. I got a very nice idea because we got some cool types of boats in this mod. Let's see if I can get anything. Well, first of all, we got the mariculture boat, and I believe Chocolate Quest also adds some boats. Or I believe it was Chocolate Quest. No, what's the other mod? Dungeon, whatever. I forgot the name, but I believe we got some more boat mods. Yeah. I'll look it up in just a minute. But what I want to make is a very simple sort of boat dock, which could be pretty cool once I actually get to use some, well, like I said, boats. And I even have some bunch more iron here and still some copper left, luckily enough. But yeah. let's get going on that. Doesn't have to be, you know, too extremely fancy, but look nice and, you know, do what it's supposed to do. And, well, I might as well break this portal down. I don't need it anyway anymore. And, man, this, this thingy, Atomic Disassembler, is so amazingly awesome when combined with, well, even with something like Obsidian, it's still very fast, like, second work, and not minutes anymore. So yeah, that's, pretty nice. So let's see, get this going, clear this out. Then what I'm thinking is possibly making this also a 3x3 pathway, which should look a little bit nicer, in my opinion. Hopefully you guys think so too. Doesn't have to be too fancy, of course. I'm not such an amazing builder. Just, you know, I'm more of a make stuff work guy than make stuff look nice guy. So yeah, that's pretty much how I roll. That's why I also usually build very basic things around making rooms and such. Pretty much similar to how Direwolf 20 basically builds. But yeah, nothing wrong with that, you know. So yeah, it should be pretty cool. Let's see, a few more pieces. Nice. And nice. I'll clean this up in just a minute. I can also get this out of the way, and I can fill it up with water in just a few minutes. So basically we got a little bit more of a space to work with around this thingy. And not have too much of a cramped area, of course. And wow, I wish I had some way of breathing underwater currently, because I do believe people like Vagrom and such have some other water or scuba suit or anything. But I have no idea yet how to use all of those stuff. But I'll definitely want to get into that. So now I got an idea of something that I used in my previous series. And I think it would be a good idea to use now too. Which is the floodgate. Yes, this thingy. It isn't too bad. So yeah, might as well make one now. And pretty much what it does is it allows you to fill in an area with some kind of liquid pretty easily. So, let me quickly get the stuff ready for that, and then I'll be right back. Okay, there we go. One aqueous accumulator, a floodgate, and some of these item duct thingies. And this should be pretty much easy to set up. I believe it's still the same as it used to be in the previous versions. So, let's see. I put this thing like right there. Then what I can do is... how do I want to place this down? I guess I can do something like right there, 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 there. And this can go right there, of course. One bucket. And two buckets. And of course I need one more of those thingies. there we go. And this should be pretty much working, hopefully. Simply quickly fill in this area without having to do it manually. Well, it's definitely outputting. Ah, yes, it's working. Nice, nice, nice. So, now I can get working on the general layout of this thing. And for that, I think we can use a cool mod called Carpenter's Blocks. Which pretty much allows you to specify the shapes and everything of certain types of blocks in some very cool patterns. And that's definitely something I want to get into. And these things are created with simply some sticks and a piece of wood. So not too insane, of course. Let's see. I should be able to do... let's see. Don't mess up. Sticks. Two stacks of sticks. Two sticks of stacks. more than enough. And then I can turn some of these into these barriers, which is also something I need quite a lot of, just because they look awesome. half a stack will suffice. Okay, let's see. Don't glitch up again. For this thing, I will also need some other tools, which are the carpenter's hammer and the carpenter's... I guess I only need the hammer for now. I think the chisel isn't really necessary yet for working with wood in a carpenter station. Or, carpenter station, that's something else. These carpenter thingies. Oh yeah, that's cool. And, still running? Huh, guess it is. I don't see where it is filling up, but I guess it's filling up somewhere. I'm sure it will work out in just a minute. So, let's see. What I can do is, first of all, extend this out just a little bit. Give myself a bit more wood. Nice. Then what I can do is go... I'm thinking that way will be a good way to head off to. So what I can do is simply there. So I'll make this also a tree wide one. This will be difficult. Can I? This will be quite annoying. Let me quickly get this going, because this will be quite annoying to do, and I'll be back in a sec. Okay, this looks pretty cool. Simply like this. Basically, what I can do sooner or later, simply put the boats in this thing and, you know, make it work. So now what I can do is get some of these carpenter thingies out. And let's see. Well, first of all, I'll get started running these also along my house just for a bit. This will make it look just a bit nicer in general, I think. And I hope so. Okay, then this direction. Basically as a little bit of a fencing off against people falling in the water. Because, well, otherwise I know I will someday fall in the water. And then I can... Basically, the cool thing about these blocks is that you can cover them up with other blocks. And if the server stops lagging, I believe we are currently having some memory leak issues, so if this doesn't work. Okay, right back, guys. Okay, guys, I also just instantly crashed after that, but now it's working again for some reason. I have no idea what just happened. Oh well, doesn't matter, it's working. So let's see what I can do. Simply do this, and this. Cool. Not looking too shabby. And then I will also, after this, probably do it on this side. And then what I can do is simply store my boats in there. And probably, I just want to make these carpenter gates. Not too bad. And then I'll put these carpenter gates above these things. So basically, I can make this all work just as the way I wanted it to, so it all looks a bit nicer, if you know what I mean. Should be cool. So yeah, let me quickly get going on something else. And well, I don't even know why I needed this carpenter thing. And I can turn these things into cool things. What looks nicer? This doesn't look too bad, actually. Now we got like an actual fence feel. Carpenter blocks. This mod keeps surprising me, actually. So cool. So yeah, let me quickly get going on what else I want to do for this episode, and I'll be right back. Okay, guys, I'm back. So, what I decided to do for the second episode is to get into a new mod that we recently got added into Resident Rise, which is still highly in development, but got some very cool stuff planned. And Pokefan, stop it. I'm trying to tell people, stop it. No. Okay, so the mod that I'm talking about is, of course, Totemic. And this guy, Pokefan, is the creator of this awesome, amazing, work in progress, cool stuff planned mod. Say hi.
Hi.
Yeah. So, I asked him to join the server right now and pretty much try to explain me a bit how this mod works, because I've seen some of the pages and a lot of people talking about it, but I've yet had the time and the opportunity to actually try it out just myself. And that's, well, why not right now, right?
Okay, so we're gonna start.
Sure.
So the first thing we need to craft is the totemic staff. It's the one just with two leaves and three sticks. So yeah, you just need to go and shear some leaves.
Sure thing.
You already have some.
Shears. I do not. Oh wait, yeah, I have some on me. Do they have to be vanilla leaves?
Oak, because I forgot to change it, so it works with others.
Well, should be easy enough. Oak sapling. And some bone meal.
Also, you need to add a way to get back up after you fall down the mine chem hole.
Sorry, what?
You need to find a way to get back up the mine chem hole once you fall down.
Well, it's not just my mine chem hole, it's just my processing stuff hole.
Oh, there's a lot of stuff here.
Yeah. I really went kind of insane on building this stuff. I've never actually made a system like this before, but it's pretty cool, actually.
Yeah.
Took quite some time to make, though. But, yeah, already 15 minutes into the episode, want to get into Totemic.
Okay, so, have you got the leaves?
No, I should have to do that, because I was attracted by you.
That's your fault.
No, it's your fault.
Nah.
And my doors keep glitching up, which is also your fault.
Apparently so. Apparently I added in Totemic. Just trying to get out of the dirt there, it's your fault.
Okay, so how many leaves do I need?
Two.
Oh, well, I got 52, so that should suffice.
Okay, now you just need to make the Totemic staff.
Okay, let me quickly look that up. Oh, just some sticks.
Yep.
Found you a bug. It ain't working. Oh, wait.
Yes, it should be.
There we go. Yeah, I messed it up. Sorry. Got it.
So.
Cool.
Now we need to create the totemic infused sapling creation thing. So for that, we'll need to make a couple of buckets of chlorophyll, and we will also need a sapling and a couple of flowers. Four flowers, four buckets of chlorophyll, and a sapling.
And how does one get buckets of chlorophyll?
Just look in any eye.
Oh, bucket of chlorophyll. Oh, not too bad. A whittling knife should easily get that. Piece of this, piece of that. Don't do that.
Nothing bad will happen.
Yet.
Actually, you should make it so if the lines cross, chop off your head. Mm. Yeah.
Do I need four separate buckets, or will I be able to recraft this thing every time?
Just one bucket.
Well, I got one bucket full of that stuff.
Okay. Have you got sapling and four flowers out?
Vanilla flowers?
Any flowers, well, any that extend flowers, so most of them should work.
I'll use some pink daffodils.
So now we need to create the ritual. So we need to get a little space like this, and all four corners need to have a bucket chlorophyll in. Also, we probably should have waited for it to be day.
Why?
There's zombies everywhere.
Oh. Ah, no infinite water pool.
Of course not.
Hey, you're an in-depth developer, who knows? Could be that you didn't think of that.
Okay, so now we'll place these blocks here, and every block here, apart from the middle one, needs to be a flower. Okay. Now place a sapling in the middle. And right click with your staff.
The infusion failed.
So now you need to get a couple more buckets and do it again.
How big is the fail rate?
It's about 50%.
Oh.
When you infuse it to a really nice staff like I have now, it'll become a lot less. And that's not meant to happen. And also, since you picked it up and I haven't fixed the bug, it turns into water.
You're evil.
No. Just really bad at programming. There's a difference.
Well, better than me. Okay, there we go. Please wish me luck.
I'm just stuck in the...
Yeah, it did something.
Okay, so this created an infused sapling. So now, if we just break this and put it over somewhere else, we need to now wait for it to grow.
No bone meal?
You can't use bone meal, but you should be able to use watering cans.
Well, I do not have a watering can.
Well, it's not hard to make.
Okay, I'll get one.
Well, you don't have to. It's just if you want it to be quick and not wait.
Well, I think my subscribers would be not like it if I would stare 20 minutes into a sapling to grow, so...
Well, the power of coasts.
Watering can. Oh yeah, it's really easy. Some of this stuff, some of that stuff. One watering can. And...
Okay, then just right click on a...
Okay, seriously, was it you that gave me the walrus?
No.
We have seriously no idea who actually did it on the server.
There's loads of them in, like, the ender chest and everything.
You need I know. And, oh, that helps.
So now you'll want to break this down, so it's using an axe or something. Or the OP thing.
Yeah, OP thing.
Ooh. So now it dropped the stuff. So how many saplings did you get?
Two.
So you got. Really? Well, you might as well plant those. They're meant to be so it's like a 1 in 5 chance. So you got really lucky.
Okay,
so
let's try this again.
Saplings.
I now have one. Let's see if I break one again.
You only need one tree's worth.
Huh?
You probably only need one tree's worth, but you got this, so.
Oh well, I want to see how bad you did your math.
No, it's not me. It's RNG. See? You got zero there.
Oh.
So, now you'll want to create the infused totemic staff, like the fancy one I have here, with the really nice rendering and stuff. And that's just a normal basic crafting recipe.
Yes. Oh, and I also got the infused leaves ready from the drop.
Yep.
Nice. Let's see.
I'll make them have more use in the future.
Good. It isn't working for me.
Well, you know, it's not normal sticks, it's infused sticks.
Oh. Well, that makes sense. I'm partially blind, you know.
Derp. No, I think the scouter helps, you see.
Yeah, well, don't blame me. Blame Pokefan. Oh, wait.
Really?
Sure.
So now you have the infused staff. So let's. So, what kind of totem are you going to make?
I look fancy.
You should start off with a basic draining and horse one. So let's go over here.
Okay.
So, first, you will probably want to craft the stuff. So you'll want to make the draining and a horse tome. So you can just look at those in any eye and then more or less just the cycle.
Oh, yeah. Cactus, horse, hopper?
Well, it's more or less a cycle, so you just make the first one, then you craft it into that, and you end up with the one you want at the end.
Okay, and what one do I need?
Well, you'll need a draining.
Oh, draining, yes.
So make one of both.
One draining and one?
Yep, you got draining, and just make a horse now. Or if you already made it.
One cactus and an horse. Yeah, got it.
Okay, so now let's place down like 3 infused wood blocks just on the ground.
On top of each other?
Yep. So right click the bottom one with your infused totemic staff. And now ones above with the whittling knife.
Oh.
You just made an extra totem structure.
Not my fault.
Yes, it is.
Okay, sorry.
Okay, so now you have the basic totem. So what you'll need to put in here now is a chlorophyll crystal. You can either go for the chlorophyll solidifier, which is kind of broken, so I wouldn't suggest using it, as in
okay.
It doesn't work properly in S&P, or you can just use the basic crafting recipe.
For a bottle of chlorophyll?
No, chlorophyll crystal.
Expensive stuff.
It's just bottles and a diamond, so it's really cheap.
Let me quickly get it. Oh, and wow, my whittling knife is almost broken.
Yep.
Why isn't it used up in recipes, but it is in, when you do real life thingies?
Because I'm very lazy and couldn't be bothered to code it. No, it was because it'd be just an annoying thing. And also, I wanted to stay away from IC2-like things.
Well, that works.
Because I didn't like the hammer.
Okay, let's see. Okay.
Learn to craft.
Oh wait, I need the saplings. 8 of those. And now I'm out of saplings after this.
You know you can make out seeds.
What now?
You can make chlorophyll out seeds.
Oh, recipe's broken. Yeah.
No, it's because you used a whittling knife, which has got durability.
Yeah, I know. That's why it's broken.
No, it's not actually bugged, because if you used it in the recipe, then it'd regain all its durability. The game makes it reset its damage values once it's used in the recipe.
But now I need to recraft one.
It's 3 sticks, an iron, and a flint. I think you can easily make it.
Hey, don't blame me.
Yes,
I'm a poor guy.
If you say so.
Okay, maybe not, but, you know. It's about the idea.
Hey, now, crystal.
Okay, and we really need to rush it up. I believe I'm already over the half an hour mark. Nice, got it.
Okay, so let's go over here. And right-click the crystal into the intelligence. Now play one of the horse totems in one of the sockets, and the draining in the other.
Okay, got it.
And luckily for us, I actually have a hoe of growth.
Flowers
not everywhere. Not a hoe of growth, just a normal hoe. So
wait, what? Why are the flowers growing around it?
Other mods do things that they're not meant to, so yeah.
That's a nice random poison ivy around my base. Okay,
wait,
so,
This... Don't say the code breaks right now.
Huh?
Well, it's not really a bug, it's that they're doing things that they're not meant to, so we'll just have to break all these blocks over here.
Okay.
I'll try and find a way to fix it, so just break, like, yeah.
Okay, but can we get on with the thingy?
Yeah, so for all this ground, I just turned it into a paddy field. And then placed down some seeds. You can use your watering can on it and make it go quicker.
Yeah.
You'll see when it grows, something really cool happen.
Need it to grow instantly?
Just wait and you'll see what happens. So it's at a high growth stage at the moment. And of course it takes a while, just because you're doing this. 57. Did you see that it grew and then grew down?
No.
Well, yeah, it grew and then grew down. That's what the totem drainer does. So when these grow, they'll grow down after a while, and that'll feed at the chlorophyll crystal. Weird Sims crystal looking thing.
And so, I guess that you can use the crystal for other stuff later on then?
You see these buffs, the speed potion.
What buffs?
That's what the chlorophyll crystal's charging.
What buffs?
When it had enough power before, it was giving us speed.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, so that's the very basic things of using it, and you'll just need to put seeds here, and you'll probably want to move it.
Yeah, well, I guess it would be a good wrapping up point for this episode. I'll probably go around messing a little bit more in the next episode. Will we continue doing this next episode, Pokefan?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, thanks for watching, guys. Please leave a rating. If you're new to my channel, feel free to subscribe. Also, Pokefriend recently started his Let's Play. Be sure to check him out. If I remember, and I probably won't, but just let me know in the comment section down below. Sure. And I will post his YouTube link.
Show this off before you end it?
Why not?
This is so cool.
Okay. And now, Kawabunga! So, hope to see you guys all next time.